What is up, everyone? Welcome to episode 12 of the Alpha Sapphire Nuzlocke. I'm JaySea. If you're enjoying the series so far, be sure to drop a like to let me know that you like it. The only way I will know is if you guys either thumbs it up or comment below. So that's your way of communicating to me, so I know you guys like it, and I will only want to upload episodes that you guys like. Anyways, last episode we went through Route 112 and we caught him a chop. And we named it Bubby after a subscriber, so if you want to be on the team and join the team, be sure to write hashtag QOTD in order for me to basically select your name out and choose you for one of our future team members. So Bubby is one of our subscribers, and he will be on the team shortly as the Machop. Anyways, what else happened? So we also went through the fiery path, and we caught ourselves My Lady Lumps, the Numble. So that's pretty awesome, and then we ended up going to that shack to heal up and rest with the lady for the night until we continue our journeys over here. Actually, I think there might be something over here as well. So let's have a look. Let's have a look at what could be over here. It's nice that we can go up this ramp with the Mach Bike. Make sure you say Mach Bike, not the Acrobite like in the video where I actually have the most views in that video. For some reason, I didn't even put much effort into that video and I got so many views for it, which is the one where you try to find the Eviolite and Gyarados site. I don't know how that got so many views, and I just kept saying Acrobite for no reason, even though I'm riding a Mach Bike. I'm just silly, okay? But anyways, you need the Mach Bike. The fast bike is the Mach Bike in order to climb up that ramp where you saw earlier. And we're going to get a bunch of these berries that I have no clue what they do. And we're going to buy an Ace Trainer. So what does this Ace Trainer have to say? By the way, I'm trying not to overlevel my Pokemon because I believe the next gym is Flannery. And I have a thing for Redhead, but shh, quiet on that. That will probably be in a question of the day in a future upcoming episode. Maybe, maybe not. Maybe, just hint, hint. Anyways, I've actually been uploading like crazy. I've actually made so many videos in the past few days. It's just insane how many I made. I didn't think I was capable of it, but I am. And you guys will be in for a treat because I don't know when you're going to see this episode in particular, but you're going to see a range of videos from like heavy edited videos that take like hours and hours and maybe days on end to videos that are like Wi-Fi battles, Nuzlocke's, what else? I think that's about it. Maybe there's more. There's actually more, but I'm not going to spoil it because it's just going to be a surprise, guys. It's going to be a surprise. Suicidal's gonna learn Thunderfang. Ooh. Thunderfang is 65 base, 95 accuracy, it has a chance to flinch and paralyze. It's also physical, this is also 65, it's 100% accuracy, but it doesn't let you flinch. I mean, we have a Volt Switch, but let's get Thunderfang first, and if we ever want Volt Switch back, we can always teach it with a TM. That's my logic behind it. If I ever miss Volt Switch, that's what we do. Aries is Swellow, level 25. Guys, how are you enjoying this overlay? And I also have a question, which is actually the question of the day. That's my question. Wait, but before I do that, I noticed that he is a ground fire type, so I have to switch out. Maybe I'll go into Beats, give Beats a bit of a chance to shine before we deposit him, unless we want to deposit someone else. I really, really want to keep Beats now. Like, Beats looks so powerful. But yeah, the question is, what is your favorite legendary Pokemon? What is it, guys? Make sure to type down below. Let me know what it is. I would really love to know. For me, what my favorite Pokemon is, favorite legendary Pokemon is going to have to, what does Amnesia do? It's going to have to be the Articuno. Special defense is drastically raised. Articuno, why? Because I'm a Gen 1 player, okay? If you guys don't know, oh my god. Magnitude's, ooh. That was a very, very hard-hitting magnitude. That was quite scary. Made me stop talking. But yeah, Articuno, because I'm a, okay, so when you answer the question of the day, make sure you say the Pokemon and answer why you like it. For me, Articuno, because I'm a Gen 1 player, and like Articuno is just so beautiful. Those of you who don't know, I'm pretty sure you all know. Oh, why does it keep critting? Okay, we're going to just switch out because this Numbo is a crit machine. I wasn't paying attention if it used focus energy or not, but that hurt. Yeah, good. That would be so scary if that actually affected Ares as well. Like that's a dead Ares. Ares is so frail, so I love that cry so much. What is your favorite cry? What is your favorite Pokemon cry? Because my one has to be the Numble. Hands down, has to be the Numble. And we are going to face a Cresselia, who is going to not take an Aerial Ace well at all. Not at all. Not at all. I want to do accents. Like, for example, if I was to read the question of the day in an accent, I would be like, what is your favorite legendary Pokemon? What accent is that? Let me know, actually. What accent is that? I don't know, because I might think it's one accent. I'm thinking it's an English accent, but when it comes out, it could be different. It could sound completely terrible. For all I know, that could have been a terrible impersonation. What the heck? What the heck? Please don't battle me. Hey! The road here was pretty long, huh? I got tired enough that I had to take a little break. Jerry, your Pokemon look pretty tired themselves. Let's heal them for a sec. Your team was fully restored. There, that's a bit better. I'm on my way to pay a visit to Professor Cosmo. He's a famous researcher from meteorites. He was working on a project with my dad. Professor Birch, why do they keep doing that? On how meteorites might affect Pokemon. I know exactly what a meteorite does, actually, but I'm not going to spoil it. Shh. Enough dawdling. I think it's not much further to Fall Arbor. Let's give it one last push. Okay. We're almost at Fall Arbor, but Lava Ridge is the place. And this is Route 113. So let's ride Route 113. Get off our bike. That cry sounds like a Sandshrew. We're gonna catch a Sandshrew today? I don't know. What is that sound? 113, Route 113. What is the encounter? It is a Sandshrew. I mean, I didn't like specifically try to find a Sandshrew, but there's the Sandshrew. Oh, could we use a ground type here? Like, should we use a ground type in our team? That is the question, because that could be a potential, okay? Like, if something dies, we really need a ground type. I guess Sandkip's our ground type right now, but the heck? Swift. That did nothing. Sandshrew is physically offensive, so it would make sense for that to happen. I'm so scared. If a headbutt kills, then I'm lost for words. Okay, good. It doesn't take it out, and we should be able to catch it now. It's very questionable why it keeps using a Swift. Is that how the bot is programmed? Like, that's not a very smart bot to be programmed to use Swift, which I'm pretty sure it has better moves to use, and that would be stronger against Lunoon. Or Hendrix. Who's stronger against Hendrix? We are going to catch it! We're going to catch the Sandshrew. Guys, we have to be very careful in a Nuzlocke because I'm so scared. I don't want to lose anyone. Everyone is dear and special to me. Everyone is... We're all friends. We're all friends. No one needs to die, right? Right, guys? Like, let me know down below. Should anyone need to die? Also, answer the question of the day. I'm not sure if I said that already. But, Sandshrew. Let's have a name for our Sandshrew, right? Sandshrew. A ground type. Ground type Sandshrew. Let's name him Kalozar. For any people that play WoW back in the day, back in vanilla WoW, there was a guy that's very famous, a very famous guild leader, guild master, if you will, named Kalozar, and he is a monster, okay? He he is like world first everything. Well, not world first, but maybe server first, okay? Not that huge, but he is amazing. He's like a true leader. And we are going to keep Suicidal in the lead, why not? I'm very scared because if I'm not mistaken, actually there's something here. Oh, nothing's there. If I'm not mistaken, there's kids here, and some of these kids have a coughing or a wheezing, and if that happens, then they might explode. If I see a coughing or wheezing, I might have to switch to Matang and take, and he should be able to take an explosion or self-destruct quite easily. Trapinch is ground or dragon ground? Not sure if it's dragon yet. Dragon ground? Dragon? Huh. Let's go into Hendrix. Arena trap, never mind. Quick attack? We definitely. Whoa! I can't do much about Arena Trap, and if it. I'm so sorry, Suicidal. I'm so sorry. Please forgive me. If you want, let me know down below in the comment. Suicidal, if you want me to pick you another Pokemon in the future, I will be fair and put you back onto the list, and then I'll randomize. I'll just randomize a subscriber name. So, comment down below if you want that. I do apologize. That you did have to go that early, but like the name kind of spells danger, right? But wow, that Trapinch though. Echoed voice is really nice. I like it. Beats. You got this, Beats. I think like Suicidal was also underleveled, to be fair. Like that was quite unfortunate. Unfortunately, I don't have time to edit it, so I won't be able to update this overlay until the beginning of next episode because it does. Oh wow, they're trying to rub it in our face by putting Suicidal on the other team. That is not cool. That is not cool at all. That is so not cool, guys. Do you see this, guys? Hashtag mean. Whoever this trainer is, hashtag mean trainer down below. That is so mean. So yeah, comment down below, Suicidal, if you would like another shot as a new team member on our team, because I'm sure like shenanigans like this will happen, and then you know. And then we'll need new team members. Very unfortunate, but we did lose one today. I think we are at 15 minutes right now, so we do have 5 minutes to try to traverse through this route, which is 113. If I'm not mistaken, we caught something at route 113 already. Oh yeah, it was the Sandshrew named Kalozar. So just writing that for my record, route 113. Make sure we put. So we're gonna put Suicidal at the back, and we will grab Bobby when we get to a Pokemon Center. Very unfortunate. Have a moment of silence for Suicidal. You are a great Electrike. And you will never be forgotten. You might also be reborn as someone else. I see a TM up there. A Spinda. That could have been an encounter. That could have been a potential encounter. I know that you guys want me to edit out like wild encounters like this, but unfortunately I don't actually have time to do this because it's 2 a.m. and I leave in the morning. I leave in literally hours. Literally 10 hours from now, so I have to go to sleep. I have to go pack my bags, pack my luggage, which I still haven't done because I've just been recording all day. I recorded, then went to work, and then kept recording. And let me tell you, work was insane. For those of you who are interested, I do work at Liquorland, and I got... And the nice thing about Liquorland is you get to be transferred to the different stores that they have. We get TM Double Team, which is very nice, which it could be quite useful, actually. But yeah, we get transferred to other Liquorland stores, so I was stationed at Roselands, but then they allowed me to be transferred all the way to Reesby, work there, and I noticed that their shop layout is very odd. It's like on a hill, it's on a slant, and they have a front door on the bottom of the slant, and then the top slant has a back door. And what happens was, today it rained really heavily, so the rain poured in from the back door, and then flooded the shop. Like, no exaggeration here, it flooded the shop, and it literally just destroyed a lot of stock. Like, a lot of stock. I'll probably post photos. If you guys are interested, write down below. Are you guys interested in seeing some photos of it? Because I actually have it, and I actually have footage of it. I could even make a video about, like, that day, because it's actually a lot happened. It's quite interesting. So, let me know down below. If you guys want to see that, or if you guys want to hear more about it, let me know. I'm encouraging you so much to just comment down below, because I want to interact with you guys, you know? I don't want to just be talking to a wall, because I make videos to interact with you guys. It's for the channel, it's for you guys, for us to grow, basically. And we're going to see what Covert does. The user endearingly approaches target, then steals the target's item. So it's Thief. It's a normal version of Thief. I value Headbutt. We can't get rid of Cut, so I'm not gonna learn Covert. Sandkip's 27. We have one more level to go. I believe we have one more level to go, if I'm not mistaken. That's what my note says anyway, that Flannery is 28. I mean, she's not age 28. Like, I'm pretty sure she's legal, but... Wait, I don't know what I'm doing. Why am I going to grass? I don't know. I was just thinking. But I think the Shack might have something interesting. I'm just going to run. I think the Shack has like the glass making things. The glass makers. You get some suit from the grass. You make something. Okay, we're going to go into the Shack, find out what it is, and then I'll probably have to end off the episode here because it's about 20 minutes and I need to record maybe one or two more episodes before I go to sleep, and then I have to go to cruise. So I want to try to fill up the whole week so that you guys don't miss out any content at all. It's fun to blow my glass. It's fun to blow my glass flute in time to my boss nattering. I don't know what you mean by that. This area is covered in volcanic ash. Blink, blink. I'm specifically gifted. I'm specially gifted means he's kind of cuckoo. Gifted. Blink, blink. Make volcanic ash suit sack. So that's for us to collect volcanic ash. Fill it up with volcanic ash. Once you have collected good amount, come and find me. So before we end up the episode, let's have a look at the volcanic ash thing. Suit sack. Okay, it's just used to gather volcanic ash, which, if I'm not mistaken, you go onto the grass that is different colored, and then maybe you go onto this thing. Max Ether. Nice. That will come in handy, actually, guys. Alright, that ends off this episode. I'm gonna update the overlay in the next episode, so don't you guys worry, and I'll see you all next episode. Cheers.